Water in this pitcher? Leave it up. I'm going to pour a little bit of water in. Don't leave it down there. I'll pick it up. This is my fault. So this is
okay, do we need the
no, we're not doing any of that. We don't need the oil. We're not allowed to do oil.
I'm going to go to the next one.
After we eat, we'll move that out of the way. Or you want to run it to see us.
Nation, but we'll be doing a baptism and celebrating new birth. And so we will begin by blessing this water, but first an announcement. Crossroads Kitchen ministers to women that are trying to get their lives together, and we're looking for really good cooks who might be willing to provide lunch for them during the Wednesdays in July. And so if you're interested in doing that, please speak with me or Laura. The blessing of the water, the iPad. Can you point it at me? Okay. Because I can't see it one way or the other. The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through the death and resurrection, through death and resurrection and the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we were reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who here are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And now we're ready for our opening hymn. For those of you who have prayer books, open them to page 299 for the service of holy baptism. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
Lord,
is risen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
Lord,
is risen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. There is one body and one spirit. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. One God and Father of all. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, you have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart, united to one another with pure affection, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Now we're ready for the reading from Deuteronomy. Pay close attention. I will be referring to it in my sermon.
Our Old Testament lesson is from Deuteronomy. The Lord your God is God of gods and Lord of lords, the great God, mighty and awesome, who is not partial and takes no bribes, who executes justice for the orphan and the widow, who loves the strangers, providing them food and clothing. You shall also love the stranger, for you were strangers in the land of Egypt. You shall fear the Lord your God. Him alone you shall worship. To him you shall hold fast, and by his name you shall swear. He is your praise. He is your God who has done for you these great and awesome things that your own eyes have seen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And Dick, are you reading the psalm?
Yes, sir.
You go ahead.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 145. It can be found on page 801 of the Book of Common Prayer. I will exalt you, O God, my King, forever, and every day will I bless you and praise your name forever and ever. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. There is no end to his greatness. One generation shall praise your works to another and shall declare your power. I will ponder the glorious splendor of your majesty and all your marvelous works. They shall speak of the might of your wondrous acts. I will tell of your greatness. They shall publish your remembrance.
A reading from Hebrews. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to set out for a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. And he set out, not knowing where he was going. By faith, he stayed for a time in the land he had been promised, as in a foreign land, living in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked forward to the city that had foundations, whose architect and builder is God. By faith, he received power of procreation, even though he was too old. And Sarah herself was barren, because he considered him faithful who had promised. Therefore, from one person, and this one as good as dead, descendants were born, as many as the stars of heaven, and as innumerable grains of sand by the seashore. All of these died in faith, without having received the promises, but from a distance they saw and greeted them. They confessed that they were strangers and foreigners on the earth. For people who spoke in this way made it clear that they are seeking a homeland. If they had been thinking of the land that they had left behind, they would have had the opportunity to return. But as it is, they desire a better country, that is, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God. Indeed, he has prepared a city for them.
Love God and love your neighbor. Love God, love your neighbor. And remember, Jesus expands neighbor to the world as he dies on the cross for the sin of the whole world. Well, for all that time in the wilderness, what is it we remember about the children of Israel? Focus on the word children. What did they echo in the wilderness? Wine, wine, wine. We want food. We want water. We're tired of manna and quail. We want some fine dining. Or we want to go back. There's one thing missing in that story in the wilderness. At least I cannot find it. Trouty will probably find it and call me later and correct me again and again and again. But what is it when you're in the car and you're on a long trip? What do you hear the children say? Are we there yet? Are we there yet? Are we there yet? No. Are we there yet? No. Are we there yet? No. I don't remember them asking that question. All I remember them is complaining. Wouldn't it be nice if they cried out, gosh, can we even see the promised land? Are we the beloved community yet? Are we truly free yet? How much? If they did, it was a short-term question at best. Where is the closest fast food restaurant? And let me tell you, we're tired of manna burgers and quail filet sandwiches. We want something more. But they never wanted what God wanted for them. God wanted them to love one another, to care for the stranger in their land, to care for the widowed, the orphan, the most vulnerable in society. That's what God wanted from them. What does God require? We know that from Micah. What does God require but to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly?
be perfect as your Father. I want to hear perfect music from you guys. That's what Jesus is saying today. And where's Beverly? Where'd she go? I want perfect music. I want perfect responses. I want perfect math. Be ye perfect as your Father is in heaven. We can't get to the promised land by ourselves. But one person is perfect. One person forgave and loved and prayed for his enemies even as he is being tortured and dying on being killed, executed on the cross. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Are we perfect yet? Are we there yet? Well, I think some of us are perfect. Some of us have a perfect head, not desiccated with hair. It makes all of y'all look very different, but this is a perfect head. Some of us are perfect, but none of us are totally in the kingdom of God. But we have our moments of beloved community. We have our moments in church, even in this country. I see it in the members of this church every day. I see it in the diocese regularly. I see it in you. We have our moments of perfection, however perfection is defined, by the way. I even see it in our country. Over the last few months, the majority of the country has sacrificed for the sake of the most vulnerable among us. As we've taken steps to keep our elderly and fragile and vulnerable safe, even at the expense of our livelihood, that's a Christian value. That's a Jewish and Christian value. There are moments in the life of our country where instead of being like the children of Israel, seeking after our own wealth, our own safety, where each person views liberty as doing what is right in their own eyes, as we say in the Old Testament, but we try to do what is right in God's eyes. We try to do what is right in God's eyes. I don't think we could offer a better sacrifice and gift to the founding members of our country. Liberty and justice for all. Everyone having the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That's when we'll get to the promised land. This is not the promised land. This is the promised land, our hearts. This is the promised land, our minds, our guts. That's where the promises are fulfilled. Are we there yet? Jesus is. Jesus is the way to the promised land. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Let us follow the way of Jesus. Michael Curry says, the way of love. Jesus says, the way of the cross. And one day, we will not have to say, are we there yet? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. At this point, I would like to invite Matthew and Shyla and Matthew's grandmother, if she wants to come down, for the baptism. For those of you who have prayer books, you may turn to page 301. Well, actually, yeah, 301. While they're walking down, I want to remind you that we're going to renew our baptismal vows today. They're like the Ten Commandments for Christians on some level. And it's a good time as we think about the ideals and visions of our newly born country. what our vows are as we have someone born again today. As most of you have been born again through the waters of baptism, if you'll stand right there. I'm going to give you your responses, Matthew, since I can't let you use another prayer book. Some of the questions are pretty obvious. Do you desire to be baptized? Wow, you quoted that verse in the prayer book. You could have said yes, but you said I do. He knows the prayer book. He comes to, when we had Wednesday morning Eucharist, he was there almost every time. Now, the answer to these questions is I renounce them. Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? Do you renounce evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? And then you can go back to I do on these other questions. Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love? Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord? This next question is addressed to all of you living in the kingdom of God. And your answer should be a resounding I will. It's one of the most important questions answered today. Because you are the beloved community, and Matthew becomes a deeper part of that beloved community today. Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this person in his life in Christ? Well done. So if you'll turn to page 304, and actually in your bulletin we have the baptismal covenant. Let us join with him who is committing himself to Christ and renew our baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
Oh, yes.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
These are the vows, and the answer is I will with God's help. Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will. God's help.
Let us now pray for this person who's received the sacrament of new birth. The answer is, Lord, hear our prayer to each prayer. Deliver him, O Lord, from the way of sin and death. Open his heart to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill him with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep him in the faith and community of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach him to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send him into the world and witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring him to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory. Who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen. All right, Matthew, if you'll step forward, Shiloh, if you'll come up. Let's let the screen see what's going on here. So, Matthew, stand over here, if you will, right here. So if you'll lean your head over, we'll do it. No, you put it over here. Matthew, we baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And just shake your head because we don't have the towel. All right, now stay here. We're going to say some more prayer. Can we do the prayers for the people at this point, whoever is doing that? Okay. Well, let me do the response, Dick. You stay there. Let me turn to the right page.
This morning, I would ask that you keep the Rodriguez family in your hearts and your prayers. Marco and Carol and Kayla lost their son, Mark, and brother. The Rodriguez family were members at St. Mark's for several years. And Marco was also co-senior warden with Peter Nicolaysen when Bishop Smiley was our priest. So please keep them in your hearts and prayers. The prayers of the people for today are Form 4 and can be found in your Book of Common Prayer on page 388. You are invited to add your own petitions during the silences. At the end of each prayer, please respond, "Hear our prayer." Let us pray for the church and the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation, especially remembering the Rodriguez family and the Parton family.
We remember Lee. We remember Wendy and her family, Larry, and the Haney Spencer Hodel family.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom, especially remembering Mark Rodriguez and Caitlin Parton.
We also remember Becky.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people. Strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today we remember those celebrating birthdays: Brendan King, Jesse Castle, Mike Jennings, Nancy Stewart, and are there any others? I happen to know one over there. Yes? All right. We remember all of you as you celebrate your birthday, the birthday of the country, and the birth of the latest saint in our church. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. And in their hearts, may thy peace, which passeth understanding, abide all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We also remember those celebrating anniversaries today. Gary and Jan Chickatance, Gary and Nancy Stack, and are there others? Let us pray. Oh God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon these, your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness. And that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I now invite you, as you're able, to please stand. We don't do the confession during a baptism. Just to let you know, I know what's going on. That's very unusual. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's pray. Matthew, I need your help. Maybe I need you to carry this, because I'm going to walk around and splash everybody. And then you can take that back into the kitchen when you're done. Remember that you've been sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Let's go over to Trouty. They need an extra dose. And I think we're ready for the offertory. Am I right, Laura? Are we ready for the offertory? Hit it. Remember, you've been sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Remember that you've been sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. You know, we need to go out. Let's do this one.
It's going to be the keyboard and the combo.
Oh, we need the offering taken up while the music's going on, don't we? What's that? Matthew, we need to say a prayer. Nancy Ainsman has set me straight again. Page 308, let us welcome the newly baptized. We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified. Proclaim his resurrection and share with us in his eternal priesthood. Amen. All right, now let's take up the money. Let's play some music and let's get splashed. Thank you. filled by the Holy Spirit in baptism. Mark Christ known forever.
No bark, no bark. Daddy, no bark.
Yeah.
Let him back in. Boy, shit, he stinks.
Mm.
He stinks.
Just a quick announcement, especially for those watching on Facebook Live and Zoom. Our iPad's about to lose power. But thank you for joining us today. Thank you for being here for the baptism. And we'll see you next week, 9 o'clock in the morning. And we'll have the camera working and everything.
All things come of thee, O Lord.
The Holy Communion begins on page 367 of your Book of Common Prayer. We are using Eucharistic Prayer B. Once the elements are blessed, I will bring the bread to you, and Jim will do some, and I will do some. We'll come to you so you can say in your slot. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, to forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took a cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with Mark and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them and remember that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Thank you. And now let's pray together our post-communion prayer. It can be found on page 365 in the Book of Common Prayer. Please stand as you are able. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. We're going to have a closing hymn, though we're not able to sing, but you are welcome to be seated for it while our musicians play our closing hymn for us.
Made a mistake besides me. Hallelujah.
Sorry. Wrong page. You like it? Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thank you. Will Erica Sachino. Erica Sachino. Erica Sachino. Erica. Yeah.